Hello everyone, this is Trisham Dutta and I study in SFS Guwahati. On 24th of January 2023, there was a debate competition organized at Gurukul Grammar School where I represented my school and won the Best Debater Award. The topic was the system of reservation in government institutions needs immediate reforms to achieve its goal, and I was speaking against the motion. So here I am with my victory speech. The Constitution has attempted to bring equal opportunities to the society. It is true that the drafters of the Constitution had the honest intent behind the inclusion of reservation. But now, when we look at the issue in more detail, India's reservations deviate from its purpose. What has reservation done to people in these 75 years? Can the Treasury bench members tell me that even after so long, even after so many amendments, when people are still discriminated, when Dalits are still ill-treated, what good reason makes them think that further reforms in reservations will be beneficial? Instead of debating about reforms, we must talk about removing reservation. I bet none of us in the house would even know what our caste is if filling that criteria was not a compulsion. The concept of ST, SC, OBC still exists because of reservation. Because I never cared about the caste of my best friend. I never knew which caste my benchmate belongs to. So how can we think of reforms and continue with reservation when it has not served its purpose? We are denying India of meritorious candidates. Yes, we are denying India of meritorious candidates who see them being overtaken by people with less brilliance. It is very important to realize that reservation policy was implemented for only 10 years. The backward classes should not be delayed forever to be backward. The increasing demands in reservations show that people aspire for backwardness rather than forwardness. And when that happens, the country itself stagnates. So in light of all these points, I strongly say that reforms in reservation system will make the situation worse and will not achieve what it has not. In post-liberalization India, wherein economic opportunities have led to major demographic change, the current philosophy of reservation no longer holds validity. I repeat, the current philosophy of reservation no longer holds validity. With this, I would like to conclude. Thank you for listening to me so patiently. Thank you so much.